When figuring out which lines should be in the final file, first I'll look at the lines that are the same in both versions. Line B is in both, so it should be on the final list. It may have been there at the beginning of the day, and neither of them removed it, or possibly both Jake and Rachel added it independently. Either way, we definitely want it. The same thing is true for D. Now let's look at some that are different. Rachel's file contains A, but Jake's file doesn't. There are a few different ways that this could have happened. Maybe the original file didn't contain A, and Rachel added it. In that case, we do want A in the final version. But it's also possible that the original line did contain A, and Jake deleted it. In that case, the final version shouldn't contain A. It might seem like it would be safest to just include A, since you can always delete it later. But remember that these letters could be representing code, so re-adding a deleted line could cause a bug. So without any more information, we can't really tell whether A should be in the final version or not, so we mark it as unknown. We can see that the same reasoning applies to C. And the opposite is true for E. It's in Jake's file, but not Rachel's, meaning that either he added it or Rachel deleted it. Since we can't tell these apart, we don't know whether we should include it or not.